Hi guys, Froggy the Gamer Frog is back. I'll be back, quack! And yeah, it's time for another handheld. Another 7-inch handheld. It's time for the PS7000 handheld. So let's take a look, quack! So you can see the package. So let's make unboxing, of course. It says game console. Big screen game console. HD quality. Trusty, worthy. Top 10 simulators, big screen. So here you can see. The operation system is Linux. It supports languages. Multi-languages. The emulators that are supported are here listed. Here are the other specs and a resolution by 1024x600. So let's open this up. So here you can see the device itself, quark. Let's see what else in the package. So here is one controller. If you want to play it on the TV, if you want to hook it up. But this controller is here. The analog stick is already broken, so this doesn't work really. But it wasn't my fault, of course. But this controller works. On this other, the analog stick was broken. And here's a mini HDMI to HDMI cable. And here micro USB for charging. So let's put this back again. Let's put this back. To the side. Quark. Let's take a look. So here you can see the handheld itself. Quark. So here the analog sticks feels really nice, really comfortable. The analog sticks feel maybe a little bit better than on the Pauky DX2, but the D-pad has a little, you can see, a little long travel. It's not so nice, and the buttons, the colored buttons are nice. Here are volume buttons, and here select and start. On the top we're finding 2 L and R buttons, micro USB, headphone jack, a TF card slot for your SD card. So this one came with 16 GB storage, on and off switch, mini HDMI port, so you can plug it to your TV. And another micro USB. And this are all the buttons. All the connections. So let's turn it on. So you can see it's not an IPS display. It's more like an LCD or TFT or something like this. So the viewing angle you can see is not so great. But if you look straight to the display, it's okay. Quark. So here you can find the game section, Music, Photo, Video, the File Browser and Settings. So let's go to Settings. You can change the language. You can change the theme, but I like this better. Off-screen seconds, backlight settings, you can make it more brighter or darker. So, key tone, you can change the key tone. But I prefer this one. And don't use this here. And this SIM information. So it's built 18 September 2020. So here at the beginning you can see some games that you can play. So, but let's go to the game section. Built in are no games, and the SD card has CPS, Famicom, Game Boy, Game Boy Advance, Game Boy Color, Mega Drive, PlayStation 1, and Super Famicom. On PlayStation 1 there's only Tekken, but the other sections have a lot of games. So you can see CPS, a lot of games. Famicom or NES has 825 games. Game Boy 204. Game Boy Advance. Has 827 games, so a lot of games, a lot of more than are pre-built on the PowKitty X2. Mega Drive 605 and Super Famicom 312 games. So let's go to CPS. Let's choose a game. Let's choose Alien vs. Predator. So if you want to go, so here on CPS you press select to set your coin. And if you press select and start together, here on this, yeah, you get to the menu where you can resume the game, set save slots, save state, load state, and control functions. So, but I must say, you can see it. It's a stretch display. And it doesn't matter which platform you play. The image is always stretched by 16 by 9 in every game. So on the PowKitty X2 you can choose equal proportion. This is really good. So this is a little bit a bummer. Thank you. So, this was Alien vs. Predator. Let's go to quit. Quark. So, let's see a little bit how Tekken works. PlayStation 1. Quark. Let's choose my favorite character, Eddie. In PlayStation 1 I can say that's nice. I've only have this game here, but I know that other PlayStation 1 games runs too. So this was enough from PlayStation 1. So it would be the perfect handheld if it would have an IPS screen and the change of aspect ratio. This would be really nice. Then we would have one of the best 7-inch handhelds. But we don't have it. So let's go to Game Advance again. Let's choose Sonic 3. So you can see on Sonic 3 it plays not bad, but you can see there is a little bit ghosting. The same problem that the PowerGDX 2 have. On this game there's a little bit, you can see two Sonics sometimes. So, let's go to quit. And the device has a 4000 milliamp battery inside. So, I just want to mention this. So, let's turn it off. So guys, the question is this device better than the PowerGDX 2 or the PowerGDX 2 Revision, which I owned? I must say, I don't really think so. Because if you add more games to your PowerGDX 2, then you have the better device. But of course, the PowerGDX 2 don't have 4 shoulder buttons. That's really bad. And this one has 4 shoulder buttons. So this is really nice. But it's your choice which you prefer. So, this was all from Froggy the Gamer Frog. And don't forget, I will make a Lego Adventskalender special every day up to the 24th December. So, Froggy the Gamer Frog hopes to see you soon again. Froggy the Gamer Frog is out!